Calvert, and I teach at Central College in Pella, Iowa, and I'm also a doctoral candidate at the University of Iowa. And during my time in school last year, I started a blog that's called Brassy Ladies. And it was a blog that focused on all female brass ensembles, starting in the historical context, with like the Helen May Butler Military Band at the turn of the century, and then all the way into recent times with groups such as the Seraph Brass Quintet. And the Seraph Brass Quintet at the last IWBC conference, which was in New Jersey, premiered a piece written by Catherine, and it was called Stereo. And when I found this piece, I was in love from the moment I heard it. And so I contacted Catherine for an interview because I wanted to hear about her compositional process. And that is how we connected. It's such a random thing. She lives in Saginaw, Michigan. I live in Iowa City, Iowa. So how else would we have found each other? And so our mutual connection is Michigan. I'm originally from Michigan. I was born in Ypsilanti, which is around Ann Arbor, Michigan. And so when we started talking about like what would this piece be about, we were like, well, it has to be about Michigan because we both have a mutual love. But not only do we have a mutual love, but my husband and his family have decades of pictures and memories with the Upper Peninsula, which is what you're seeing here is the Mackinac Island Bridge, which crosses from the Lower Peninsula of Michigan. Let me be very Michigander for you. From here, is that correct?
And then right? There's this other part from here.
So the Mackinac Island Bridge will take you from the Lower Peninsula into the Upper Peninsula. And so this is the picture that I think really kind of encapsulates really what we were going for, at least for the title, Borealis. But these other pictures, Pictured Rocks was one of the initial movement inspirations. And the first movement of our piece is called Color. And Catherine, this is really, you kind of came up with these titles and these inspirations.
When we first started talking about this piece, we thought it might be about Pictured Rocks, Taquamenon Falls, some of the landmarks in the UP. But as part of my research, I talked to a lot of people that actually live there. I don't live there, I've only been there a couple of times, and I asked them to tell me about the UP. Tell me what you think about the UP. And I talked to 7 different people from completely different circumstances, and every single one of them said the same 3 things in different ways. The first thing they all said was the color is magnificent. And not just the fall color, which is beautiful, but also the greens and the blues, the color of the lake, the color of the sky. The second thing that everybody remarked upon was the cold. And we'll get to some of those in a minute. They look pretty cold.
There's lots of pretty blues.
Yeah, there's a lot of pretty blues. And the cold, someone said, the cold is bitter. This was a 14-year-old girl that told me that. But she said, but it's the air is so pure. And someone also said how the footsteps in the snow, because it was so cold, the crunch was ominous. I love that idea. The third thing that everybody remarked upon was the UP, which is a huge landmass, is very thinly populated. And everyone described it as a big small town. And everyone knows each other and everyone looks out for each other. And so that sense of community is very strong because it's remote, it's extreme in its climate. And so that's where so I called Kate and I said, well, I don't think it's gonna be about places, I think it's just gonna be about the place. And so that's where we got our movement titles, which are Color, Cold, and Concord. Concord meaning the warmth between people.
And all these pictures that you see were actually taken either by myself or my mother-in-law, who is an extremely artistic and wonderful person. And these photos coming up are actually, this is her as a child, and this is her mother, so my husband's grandmother. And then that's my husband's grandfather. This is them camping on Lake Superior, and I think she said this was in the 60s, if you can't already tell by the cars. And then this is a really lovely photo of my husband as a child, his sister, and then their grandfather, showing how this has been such a generational journey for them. And then these are pictures of my husband and his father, and then our nephew and niece and his sister. So this piece really is close to home, and it's really dedicated to my husband and his family. And I also do want to take the time to acknowledge that this was a consortium effort, and so Texas State University, and Dr. Caroline Steiger were part of this consortium, the University of Iowa, with Jeffrey Agrell, Ken Gorder, Brandy Lane, and then personal donations from my family, my husband's family, and many anonymous donors as well. So this was a
joint effort.
Yeah, it was a group effort. All right, so we are